Hi, I'm Jared with Fun Science Demos, and we are back with another science story, and it's all about sound. Through science, we've discovered that anytime something moves fast or vibrates, it makes a sound. And today, we're going to try and make some of our own sounds. Today, we're taking a look at the book Too Much Noise by Ann McGovern. And in this book, an old man is frustrated because his house makes too much noise. The bed creaks, the floor squeaks, and the tea kettle whistles. The old man decides to visit the wise man of the village to figure out a way to make his house less noisy. And the wise man's suggestion is for him to go out and get a cow. And the cow makes even more noise. The old man keeps going back to the wise man to get a different answer, and the wise man keeps telling him to get another animal, and his house just gets noisier. Finally, the wise man tells the old man to get rid of all the animals, and the old man realizes that his house really wasn't that noisy to begin with. So in honor of this book, Too Much Noise, we decided to create three STEM challenges, three STEM builds that allow us to build something that makes loud noises, really loud noises. Now remember, in order for something to make a sound, it needs to vibrate or move fast, and we need something to vibrate or move fast. So for the first build, we're going to use a latex glove, or you can try a vinyl glove, or even a balloon should work. We're going to go with a latex glove, and all we need to do is cut a thin rectangular strip from the glove. I get a nice pair of scissors, and I'm just going to cut a little rectangular strip. It doesn't have to be perfectly cut along the edges. One glove, you should be able to get lots of different strips from one glove. Each finger, you should be able to get two different strips, and then the hand itself, you should be able to almost get an entire classroom of strips out of one glove. And that's what it's gonna look like. You can see it vibrating as I blow across it, and it kind of makes a sound, but if I want that sound to really get loud, I need to have a small opening around that stretched latex. And I'm going to use my thumbs. If I pinch this piece of latex between my thumbs, you'll notice my thumbs create a small opening. I can use that to blow right between my thumbs and really get a nice loud noise. Now to make this easy for kids, we're going to suggest taping this piece of latex right to the pad of my thumb. So I have a piece of tape. I'm just going to tape it to my thumb, and that allows me now to pinch and hold the latex without any problem whatsoever. So now I'm ready for my sound and loud noise. And with it taped into place, I can just now stretch it up and use my finger to pinch it to my thumb. I have a nice little opening, and now I take my other hand and I position it just like that, and I'm ready to make a loud noise. Watch to see if you can see that little piece of latex vibrating. Wow, my ears are ringing. Now it's important to point out that the harder I blow, the more quickly this is going to vibrate and the louder the noise is. I think it might be too much noise. You can even play around trying to stretch the latex tighter to see if you can get a higher pitched sound. Let's stretch it tighter. That's even a higher pitched scream. Oh, my ears are ringing. Now the next STEM build that's going to make too much noise, I'm going to need the finger of a latex glove. So let's just take the glove. I'm going to snip off the fingertip and then down at the base of the finger. And I'm going to need this tube to make my next sound instrument. So I have the finger from the latex glove. I'll need two straws and some tape. Next, we need to put the end of the straw into the finger. Now here's the little tricky part. I'm putting it at about a quarter inch to a half inch, and I'm going to wrap that latex around the straw. So now I can tape it into place. The tape's going over part of the latex and part of the straw. Now I just wrap the tape around, taping the latex glove to the straw. And I'm going to do the same thing with my other straw on the other side. So we have our noisemaker ready to go. You see the strip of latex or the finger of latex joined to two different straws. This one is much more difficult to make a noise, and it's much more difficult to see the latex vibrating. So we have a little trick to make this work here. The one straw you're going to hold up and down, and with the other straw you're going to put in your mouth. And as I blow, you're going to see the latex inflate. And you may not be able to get a sound right away. So watch, I'm not going to get a sound. I just hear air rushing out of the straw. So the technique we're going to suggest is with the straw up and down, I'm going to slowly, using my wrist, angle the straw toward myself until I hear a sound. Let's see if I can get it to work. So I actually had to bend the straw almost up to my face to get a sound. And once you get a sound, don't move your hand. You can find that it's going to make a sound every time, but it's hard to find the sweet spot. Now this noise definitely isn't as loud as our first build, and it's a lot trickier to make, but engineering is like that. You have to keep trying until you get it to work. And our third build is actually going to be very similar to this build. Our third and final build creates the loudest noise of all. It sounds like this. That is a loud noise, and we're going to show you how to build it. For this build, you're going to need a soft plastic container. A gallon container could work because we're going to be cutting a rectangular piece from the bottle. But we found the plastic soda bottle to work the best. So the first step is to cut the top and the bottom off of the bottle so we can turn the middle part into one giant rectangular piece of plastic. To do that safely, I'm going to keep the cap on the bottle so air is trapped inside. I'll use my thumbtack right around the shoulder of the bottle, push the thumbtack in to make a hole. Now I'm going to use a pencil, a sharp pencil, to make that hole bigger. Just want to twist and push, and now I should be able to get my scissors into that hole and safely cut the top part of the bottle off. There's going to actually be a line on the bottle, but you could draw a line on this if you wanted a nice straight line. You could put a rubber band around that to get a nice straight line, and now I'm going to cut down the side and cut off the bottom. Now I have a nice big piece of rectangular plastic. Now I need to cut a strip off of this plastic piece that's about as wide as my thumb. You don't need an exact measurement for this. You do want to make it as straight as you possibly can. The next step is to roll this piece of plastic up to create a tiny little tube. So I'm just going to pinch it, start to roll it up on itself. And now I need to tape it in place. It should be just about big enough to fit into the neck of a balloon. If it's too big, you're going to have to stretch the balloon. If it's too small, it'll slide down. So you might have to experiment with the perfect size. Now I'm going to use a piece of tape to tape it in place. You want to make sure you tape this really well so it doesn't open up. If there's any sharp edge, you might want to run a piece of tape over that sharp edge because the sharp edge could poke a hole in the balloon. And I have my little plastic tube ready to go. Now I've trimmed our bigger piece of plastic into smaller little pieces of rectangles that I can roll up to make into a tube. So let's pick one. We're going to roll this up. Now this does not have to be as small as the little nib I made here. This is going to be my mouthpiece, and I want my balloon to be able to stretch over the end without too much difficulty. So I'm going to make it about that big. Take a piece of tape. Now I need to tape it in place all around the top part. Then I'm going to tape the other end. And then finally, I'll tape the middle. Now, the next step is the hardest step. In fact, it's easier if you have a partner to help you do this. You're going to try to put this little nib inside the neck of this balloon without it dropping down into the balloon. So it's very helpful if you have a partner who can hold open the balloon. I think I can use my fingers and thumb to hold it open and drop the little plastic nib down into it. The nice part is once it's in, you want to try and get it nice and centered and straight so the neck of the balloon isn't off to one side. And I think you can see I have it stretched right in there. I want enough of the rubber balloon to have to stretch over my mouthpiece. So I think I'm going to move it down just a little bit by stretching and pulling. All right, I think I'm ready to go. Now we need to stretch our mouthpiece over the end of the balloon. This one shouldn't be as difficult, but again, maybe you need a partner to help hold it. Now I'm ready. I need to have a section of balloon that when I fold it back onto itself, I create a thin membrane, and that's what's going to do the vibrating. That's what's going to make the loud noise. Let's see if this thing works. Now, this thing's easy to inflate, but it's difficult to get a sound. You have to do just the right angles. We're going to stretch it like this, and if I don't have enough balloon in between the little nib and the mouthpiece, I may not get a sound. And if I'm not holding these pieces at the right angle, I may not get a sound. So we're going to blow this up and see if it makes a sound. Watch carefully to what I do. See me angle it this way to get the sound as loud as I possibly can. And you might need to move this down lower or higher to get a louder sound. Here we go. I'm going to fold it back on itself and blow it up. Now I'm pinching it so it doesn't let any air out. So here we go, let's try and get a sound. If I bend it too far, it stops making a sound. Now if you had a partner who squeezed on the balloon, I can make that loud noise even louder. Imagine an entire classroom of students making sound and sound waves for all the world to hear. That's too much noise! We'd like to give a huge shout out to Ann McGovern and her awesome book, Too Much Noise, for inspiring all of our loud noise-making STEM challenges today. If you want to learn more about sound or sound waves or anything relating to science, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, and sometimes it's noisy. Thanks for watching.